Hello guys, I'm KIRI, welcome back to my channel. Today we're gonna talk about one of the best 90s car, Ferrari 512 TR. Ferrari 512 TR actually means Testarossa, was a facelift or updated version of the original 1984 Ferrari Testarossa. Was in production from 1991 to 1994, when was replaced from the other facelift or let's say new model Ferrari 512 M. Here M is coming from Modificata. When the original Ferrari Testarossa came in 1984, was absolutely new radical design. Was very powerful, 390 horsepower, very fast, 290 km per hour or 180 miles per hour, and was the real rival of the best car of the time, Lamborghini Countach. Straight away, of course, the car became the world famous poster car, the dream car for everyone. But in 1991, the car was already 7 years old, and the other great cars came on the market, cars like Jaguar XJ220, Lamborghini Diablo, of course, Bugatti EB110, even new models from not that much expensive brands like BMW 850i, Mercedes-Benz 600 SL, so they needed to make a change. And of course, the new models came, Ferrari 512 TR. How I said, in the beginning was an updated version, so the chassis and the body was the same, just new bumpers, new engine lead, new wheels and tires, of course, the suspensions are new, and of course they updated the engine from 390 horsepower of the original Testarossa, now 428 horsepower, so 38 horsepower more. And of course the performance of the new model was better. Just to compare with the original 1984 Ferrari Testarossa, both cars, they have the same capacity engine, flat 12, 4,943 cc. So the original Ferrari Testarossa, 390 km per hour, here, 390 horsepower, here 428 horsepower. 290 km per hour, the original Testarossa, here the new model, 314 km per hour. Acceleration from 0 to 100 km per hour or 62 miles per hour. The original Testarossa 5.3 seconds, the new Ferrari 512 TR 4.8 seconds. But the big difference was on the road, because the new model is with more stiff suspensions, bigger brakes, 18-inch wheels compared with the 16-inch to the 1984 Ferrari Testarossa, and of course the low-profile tires. Compare with the old ones, so the big difference, how I said, was on the road. So all these updates makes huge difference on the road, and the driving experience is completely different from the 1984 Ferrari Testarossa. How I said, Ferrari 512 TR came in 1991, was in production until 1994. In total they make 2,261 of this beautiful model. The wheelbase of the car is 2m550, the car is long 4m480 and is wide 1m976. The car is high just 1m135mm, the curb weight is little bit over 1 ton and 600 kg. The engine is the same with the original Testarossa, actually it's not the same, we're gonna talk about this little bit later, but it's flat 180 degrees, 12 cylinder, the same capacity 4.9 liter, 4,943 cc, longitudinally rear mounted, each cylinder has 4 valves and producing 428 horsepower and 491 newton meters of torque. Many people think, how I said before, the engine is the same, but actually it's not. Here we have Nikazil cylinders, new air intakes, Bosch management is new, of course, larger intake valves, so all these things improve the power from 390 to 428. From the acceleration from 0 to 62 miles per hour or 100 km per hour, how I said before, 4.8 seconds. The quarter mile from standing, 13.2 seconds. And the maximum speed is 314 km per hour. Also, some changes they make in the interior as well, compared with the original Testarossa. And how I said before, again with the wheels, they are 18-inch wheels here to this model Ferrari 512 TR. 8-inch on the front white and 10.5 on at the rear. The tires, of course, they are Pirelli, and on the front the size is 235/40 ZR18, and on the rear 295/35 ZR18. The disc brakes, of course, they are bigger, on the front 315 mm, on the back 310 mm. And then the updated, another update, Ferrari F512M Modificata, they made from this car only 501, and this one maybe is the most rare from all the three modifications. Just 501 were made. The power is even more, 440 horsepower, acceleration better, 4.7 from 0 to 100 or 62 miles per hour. The maximum speed is 315 kilometers per hour or 196 miles per hour. And the quarter miles from standing 12.7 seconds compared with 13.2 to the 512 TR and 13.5 to the original Testarossa. So the Testarossa name is coming from the winning World Sport Class Championship 1957 model Ferrari 250 Testarossa. And Testarossa, actually there are two words, Testa and Rossa, in Italian mean red head, because the cam covers of the engine being painted in a red color, and from there the name Ferrari from 1957, actually the name is coming Testarossa. The 1984 Ferrari Testarossa actually was a successor of the model Berlinetta Boxer. The design was made by Pininfarina with the main designer Leonardo Fioravanti, who created actually many other great Ferrari models. Leonardo Fioravanti was as well a very good aerodynamist, so on the end the drag coefficient of the Ferrari Testarossa was just 0.36, because this is very big car actually on the back, that's why the drag coefficient 0.36 is very good, which is amazing. Just to compare, the Lamborghini Countach back on the time, the drag coefficient was 0.42, so you can see the difference between Lamborghini Countach 0.42 and Ferrari Testarossa 0.36, which, how I said, is amazing. And of course, because of the design, the car became the most famous poster car, together with Lamborghini Countach and a little bit later with Ferrari F40. The sides air intakes are very, very well known. Everyone knows them and recognize the car straight away. Even the people who don't really like cars, when they saw Ferrari Testarossa, they can recognize the model. So it was a very, very cool car. Still today, maybe the people do not appreciate enough the model, because on the end they built near 10,000 of all the three modifications, including the original 1984 Ferrari Testarossa, with 7,177 cars were made. And then Ferrari 512 TR, what we have here today, 2,261 in total were made, and the last one, the Modificata version, F512M, actually in Italian, Modificata mean modification, from F512M they built just 501 cars in total, from 1994 to 1996, when the model finally was replaced by Ferrari 550 Maranello. The problem of the Testarossa model has always been the weight distribution. The original Ferrari 1984, which was presented for the first time at the 1984 Paris Motor Show, has a weight distribution 40% on the front and 60% on the rear. So this is not good for the road with high speed, when you're cornering, it's not good to have that big difference between the front and rear axle. Then the car, what we have here today, actually the Ferrari 512 TR version, which been presented at the 1991 Los Angeles Motor Show, the weight distribution is a bit better, 41% on the front and 59% on the rear. which was some improvement compared with the original 1984 Ferrari Testarossa. And then the last version, Ferrari F512M, the Modificata, again was introduced at the Paris Motor Show, but 10 years later, so in 1994, after the original Ferrari Testarossa, the drag, the weight distribution actually was improved again, this time 42% on the front and 58% on the rear. Was the better variant, the Ferrari 512M, actually was the better variant of the all three models. But the good side of the Testarossa models were the position of the engine, also because it's flat, so the position is very, very low, and the center of the gravity is low as well, so in the middle of the car, which helps for the handling on the road. The gearbox of the Ferrari Testarossa is 5-speed manual for all the three modifications, and for the car what we have here today, the Ferrari 512R, you can see here the rear tires 295/35 ZR18. Compared with the original Ferrari Testarossa 1984, the rear tires are 255, so you can guess the difference on the handling. So the gearboxes are, for the all three modifications, they are 5-speed manual dogleg with the first gear left and down. Of course, this means dogleg. And how you can see here, the backside of the car, the 512TR on the boot lid, of course, it's amazing. So TR, how I said, coming from Testarossa, which means head, red head. So the car is very, very wide when you looking from the back. It's 1 meter 980 approximately, which, but because it's very slim, so that's why the imagination of the car is very, very, very wide. And you can see the difference here, the boot lid, actually the engine cover lid is different than the original Ferrari 1984 Ferrari Testarossa, as well with the four exhausts, two on the left side and two on the right side, and the emblem on the grill on the back side. It's absolutely, absolutely beautiful, amazing car in this red color. Of course, Ferrari red is maybe the best for Ferrari Testarossa. Also, the white color is very famous because of the American movie Miami Vice. But the red one, anyway, is the best color for any Ferrari, especially from these years, from 1970s, 80s, 90s. And still today, the red color is the best for Ferrari. So, guys, I hope you liked the video about this updated Ferrari Testarossa version, Ferrari 512TR. If you like the video, please subscribe my channel, and see you next time, guys. Bye!